All right, it's Ben here.
And Kevin.
And this is match three in our, what was last week's date, 14th?
Yes.
No. That was 7th. So this is April 7th, 2017. This is, we only had six people, so we just did three rounds. This is the finals. That's actually me on the right-hand side. On the left-hand side, we have Aaron. I am running Imperial. I've got it. It's a 98-point build because I want to make sure Whisper fires first so I can cloak. I'm running with Captain Crunch, Captain Aachen, which if you bump in, if he, when he moves, if he runs into you, then you take a damage. I'm running it with Kylo Ren, Palpatine, and Expertise. Kylo Ren allows me for my action to assign, I'll show you the dark side, which you can pull a pilot, you pull a pilot card out of the, you tell your opponent which pilot card you want to pull out of the deck, and you place it on the, I'll show you the dark side. Then if any ship hits that ship with a crit, he takes that,
the chosen card,
that chosen card, and it goes through his shields. Palpatine, I get to choose. I get to choose my die for one roll, but I have to do it before I roll. And I'm running with Expertise, which allows me, if I'm not stressed, to flip all eyeballs to hits. Running Whisper, which Whisper says if I hit someone, I get a focus.
You get a focus when you attack.
When I attack. I'm running Agent Callus, which otherwise known as Agent A-Hole, and he does some hating on some people. So what I do is I choose somebody at the beginning of the one ship at the beginning of the match, and I get to change one eyeball result to a hit for free, and if he attacks me, then I get to change one eyeball to an evade. So I get my swerve on. I'm running a Veteran's Instincts, which pumps me to 9 for my pilot skill. Advanced Cloaking Device, which when I hit, or when I attack, I can perform a free cloak action. And Fire Control Systems, which when I attack, I get a free target lock on the person I attacked.
Yep.
And Aaron.
Pretty standard Whisper loadout. Aaron, by the way, Your freaking Palp is really good.
My what?
Your Palpatine is really good.
Just my Palpatine?
Yeah, your Palpatine. You don't need Kylo. Palpatine and Kylo are evil in the same list. That's all I gotta say.
Well, it's if I use them. I ended up not using them a lot here because I ended up taking target lock most of the time. Well, I know I used it pretty decently on this one. But half the time I do end up taking target
lock. It's because Kylo's in action.
Kylo's in action, right? If I take a target lock, then I can re-roll them with Expertise in play. I have a really high chance of flipping eyeball, getting 4 or 5 hits. Because anything that doesn't hit, the target lock, I get to re-roll. And there's a high chance I'm going to hit in 2 rolls.
Huh. Okay.
So I do that. And I'd rather have those extra hits than maybe some of the other effects of the pilot cards. Especially if I've already got, I'll show you the dark side on somebody, and they're already pilot still 0.
Yeah, that's the one thing that I like about Kylo that I don't think a lot of people really pay attention to is I don't think the best choice is always blinded pilot. Yeah. I think that's kind of wasting a lot of the long-term value of those crit cards. What is the one that where they take damage whenever they hit another ship or an asteroid?
I can't remember.
But, I mean, that card could really mess up like a blocker.
Yeah.
If you could get that card on like a PS1 ship like the Outer Rim Smuggler, it could really do some damage there.
Now here, I don't know if I did it, but what I should have done is target, I'll show you the dark side on Jake Farrell, because if my hits do get through, I only need 2 hits on him.
Right.
To kill him, because I can go through his shields instead of 4. Right, because I'll throw you the dark side. So we'll see. So what's Aaron running over there?
So Aaron's got a very rarely seen pilot card for the Falcon, which is the Outer Rim Smuggler. He has reduced stats across the board.
But it allows him to run a Falcon and 2 other ships, which is with lots of cards on him. I've never seen this build, but it can be effective, especially with the Falcon as a blocker.
It's a very low cost Falcon. It has two less hull and one less shield than a normal Falcon, and one less red dice. I think the biggest problem with it is the one less red dice. He did run the original Millennium Falcon title, which I think does some work for him. And engine upgrade gives him some options to make it a better blocker, to be honest.
Yeah, boosting with a large base ship is really powerful. You can cover some distance.
I probably would have done something else with the 2 points for Bistan, because I don't think when you only have two attack die, do you need... You're going to get many opportunities to change one to a crit.
Yeah, yeah. I would consider something else on that one as well. Just to see. At a minimum, because I think it's the same cost, C-3PO. Because then he gets auto... He's three? Okay.
But...
Bistan's only two?
Bistan's only two.
Oh, wow. Okay.
He's also range one to two. So, you know, he gets eyeball to a crit. I just don't think it's that valuable on a ship with only two attack dice. But, yeah. You know.
Yeah, but I can't believe he's only two. Well, yeah, you'd have to look and see. It'd be hard to choose. Is Lando two or three?
I think Lando's three.
Okay.
I think. Anyway, Jake.
You're right. If he had more attack die, it would make sense. But, I mean, he's able to flip it on me several times when he hits, I believe, during this match. But, yeah, it's hard with two. What's Jake Farrell do?
So Jake Farrell, you assign a focus to... When he receives a focus token, he does a barrel roll or a boost.
Okay.
By the way, a A-Wing, which is the small ship that Jake is flying, does not natively have a barrel roll.
Oh, so you don't even have to have it on your...
Yes.
As one of your possible actions to be able to do the boost, the barrel roll action. Oh, that's smart.
He does have push to limit, which basically means he's always going to take a focus token so he can get the extra maneuverability.
Yeah.
So he can basically get three actions out of that ship.
Which, if he uses them all for movement, it's
You can't do the same action twice.
Right. Well.
So he can barrel roll and boost and get a focus.
Okay, so Predator, he gets to re-roll a dice.
Re-roll one dice.
Unless your pilot ability is two or less, and then you...
Which it doesn't matter. Well, two. I guess it would matter if someone got pilot skill zero from a crit card.
Yeah.
Test pilot gives him the ability to fit two EPTs, a.k.a. Predator and push the limit. Chart and refit uses up his missile slot, but reduces the cost of his ship by 2 points. And then he's got a ship that, honestly, I think should see more play. Wedge Antilles is a pilot skill 9 T-65 X-Wing. His ability is nasty against high agility ships like Whisper. He reduces the agility dice by 1 when he shoots.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. I did my mod on my Whisper, if you'll look in the lower right. I put a read switch and an LED, and so when you put a magnet on the bottom of my cloaking token, so when you stick it on the base, it lights it up blue. Just kind of fun. I was bored on a Saturday, so there we go.
Wedge also has BB-8, which also the T-65 X-Wing does not have a barrel roll, but... When you perform a green maneuver and you have BB-8 equipped, you get to do
a barrel
boost.
A boost?
No, it's a barrel roll.
Is it? Okay.
Because BB-8. Because barrel rolls. Because he rolls all over the place.
Okay. Oh, that's true.
Barrel roll. And he also has Predator to get a reroll, no matter what. And proton torpedoes, which is a four-dice attack. Wedge's ability still works with the proton torpedoes.
Okay.
Now he's shooting four dice at you, changing an eyeball to a hit, and he's reducing your agility by 1 when he does it.
Okay.
So
we were questioning on the last time we were commenting on Aaron it's 5 points, right? That's a lot.
I think proton's 4.
Proton's 4? No, we said it was 5 last
time.
You were
thinking of ion torpedoes.
Ion torpedoes.
Ion torpedoes.
With Pat's match, okay. So I'm just explaining how my decloak works, and you can when you you have to announce your decloak before you reveal your movement dice, and or your movement dial, and then you decloak before everybody else moves. So
I take it back. It's an eyeball to a crit with proton torpedoes.
Oh, that's good.
Your first eyeball becomes a crit with a proton, and when you compound that with Wedge's ability, it becomes a really lethal attack. So, yeah, about that.
All right, so with Outer Rim Smuggler, he's...
I don't know. Why did he... What do you think he was thinking by putting Outer Rim Smuggler on the outside like that?
Well, I think he didn't realize it was that far out. He's trying to keep it at... He's trying to keep it at arm's length so he can fly around and take pot shots at me while I'm focused on the other ones.
I think that... I'll be honest. I think if you're going to run somebody like Outer Rim Smuggler, use it as a large base blocker. Because PS1, which means it's going to move before almost every ship in the game.
Oh, so you can position yourself to
mess
somebody up.
And running a large base ship as a blocker, I mean, that just opens up.
Okay, I'm showing him the dark side. I forget which one I had and choose. I think I'll hold it up to the camera. I think it might be Pilot Skill Zero. We'll see. It's either Pilot Skill Zero or Blinded Pilot.
Which ship did you assign it to?
On camera.
I did show it. Damaged Cockpit. I think
that's Pilot Skill
Pilot
Zero.
Skill Zero. Yep. By the way,
I believe it was on Wedge. I can't remember though, because Wedge was 9. Yes, it's on Wedge.
Ooh, drop Wedge from a 9 to a 0. That's nasty. You mean person. That also takes some of the utility of using BB-8 out. Because now
okay, so this is the only this is the only bad move that Aaron made the whole game, turning left in front of me.
That does seem like,
because all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get behind him and I'll stay behind him the whole rest of the game. That's he should have. I don't know. Going left was probably not a
well. I mean,
plan.
To be honest, I mean,
maybe he was trying to draw me away for Outer Rim Smuggler, but because he turned away from me and I turned into him, I'm on his tail the whole time and he doesn't get any shots off. This is really, after this he flew like really well. It's just this one move I think kind of set me up for getting in close with Whisper, and I got 5 hits a couple times with Whisper.
Oh Lord.
Yeah.
4 attack dice is really strong. There's no two ways about that. 4 attack dice is ridiculous.
So we thought I might have bumped, but I did, but it was ship to ship, not base to base.
So Whisper rolls right up under Oinkin and just gets snuggles right up under that large ship, doesn't she?
Because I thought he was going to fly in formation, and he ends up doing it, so I wanted to give a chance of being an arc with Whisper.
Okay. Oh, so you...
That's why I moved right.
You thought Wedge was going to swing over there.
Yeah, I thought Wedge was going to swing over or try to go forward and do a
K-turn.
And
he does. He makes a left turn.
Oh, so after his first move, I knew he was probably going to fly in formation to the left.
It does seem like a really...
So I think I do either a 2 or a 3. Oh, no.
That seems like a really...
Yeah, I did a 3 to get up there. He didn't realize I was coming in so quick. But because Oinkin bumps, I want to try to get in there and bump on one of them and shoot the second.
Right. No, that makes complete sense. What does he think? I mean, the only thing I can see that he might have been trying to pull off here was to bring the Outer Rim Smuggler in there and like use him as a blocker and try to stop you from chasing his ships across the table where Kate turned them and swung around. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, he kept going toward that corner, did K-turns, put the Outer Rim Smuggler in the way of your ship. The spacing is all wrong there.
Yeah. No, but it's still, I mean, him turning left in front of me, I think, was the only bad decision this game that he made.
I mean, maybe he thought he had enough green dice to get away with it.
So I palped a crit there. So his, I'm pointing out that the this one takes effect. So I told him it goes through the shields. Taken back. I'll show you the dark side and let's see which one. I think it's...
Well, what would you do if you had your Wedge and Tellies turn from a 9 to a 0? Would you just go, hey, this is my new blocker?
Yeah, I think so. I'm not sure which one I did because he should have taken a hull. Danielle's not caught up yet.
No. I think you took a hole in a shield.
Yeah,
I think
so you had 2 on. It's a casual game, so we're doing all the actions for Whisper that we forgot to do. It was nice to let me
do
that.
You got a hole in a shield on Wedge.
Okay, so he's pilot skill 0 on Wedge. So that's the power of doing it. I mean, a lot of people go after that blinded pilot to not get the attack, but...
Well, I mean, if you know it's going to prevent a range one shot from someone that's going to hit with 5 dice,
yeah,
it could be worthwhile.
Or I used it. I used it the round before this one to prevent Dengar from doing the fireback and arc. So that was worth it right there because he was at range one, so I was able to fire on him and he couldn't fire back. Right, but
he's at range one, so it would have been a 3 or 4 dice.
And I was out of his arc.
Yeah.
So.
Huh.
All right, let's see. I think he's rolling for that dude.
He got a little bit. Yeah. He didn't come back. I mean, he didn't take a whole lot of damage in that turn. I'm surprised was Whisper the one that got the hits in?
No, Whisper didn't. He was able to deal with all that. It was because Whisper fires first. So it was all Oinken got a crit and a hit.
Oh, wow. Oinken did the damage, huh?
Yeah. Oinken did the damage, hitting a crit, and it went through the hole. So.
Wow. Wedge must not know how to roll green dice.
All right, so this one, I think he jets off, but I think I'm able to catch him. I think I do a 3 easy and come up alongside him. But what I've learned with Whisper, doing a hard 1 and then a barrel roll really gives you a lot of maneuverability. And I find if I use more than a 1 range once I'm close in like this, I put me right out of the game because it's too big of a move for him, especially if I'm decloaking to begin with, which is a 2. So you do a 2 and then a 1, which is basically a 3 maneuver.
Yeah, and
for decloaking, and that's enough movement. If you're decloaking, what I've learned is it's you have to have a good excuse, in my opinion, to do something other than a range 1 afterwards.
Like a 1 hard or 1 bank.
1 hard. Well, it depends on where you're. Peeps are, but generally I've been doing a 1 hard because it flips me 90, and then barrel roll, I'm able to zero in to move my arc to get it so I can hit him. So here, I think I'm gonna do a 1 and to flip around, and it'll be right up his butt, and I think I might boost forward, so I'm like range 1 right behind him.
Well, so often a 1 hard is the right answer with Whisper.
It is, but well, especially after decloaking. So,
yep,
I was trying to get too much distance, and it's more finesse. So that's the whole reason I started playing Whisper is I wanted to learn how to fly better, and it forces you to really think and plan.
So, what do you think he's gonna do with the stinking outer rim smuggler?
He's coming in, and then he'll boost to try to get into range 1.
Like a 2 bank.
I think 2 bank and boost, or 2 bank and or boost.
Well, I think, is there a rock right hiding behind Oinken?
No, I don't think, I can't tell. Yes, maybe, I don't know. Let's see what he's doing.
He did a 1 straight.
He did a 1 straight, oh, okay.
He's not in a hurry to get anywhere. No, I think there is a rock there, which...
Oh, okay, would prevent him from...
Would be the reason he wouldn't do a turn there.
So is he focusing? He's focusing. Oh, no, he's target locking. Okay.
Huh.
I don't know. That's a hard decision to make. Target lock with only two attack dice. I would have focused. I think the statistics are better, probably. But at least you get a whole full reroll if you got two pieces of crud.
Right. I mean, I think the statistics are better. But the thing is, with a focus token, you get to use it for defense or offense. He does still get one defense dice.
Yeah.
I mean, if he really wants to make the ship annoying and keep it on the table, he can just take an evade. But
I don't
realistically think you're going to shoot at him at this point.
No, I leave him to last. And I can't remember. I think I did what I've always said on here that you should really rethink yourself about doing, is I couldn't resist the range one. I think I went after Jake. But we'll see what I did. Because I really should continue firing on Wedge, but I think I couldn't resist the range one.
Yeah, I think Wedge. You know, neither one of these ships really scare you that much, but I think Wedge is a little bit more worrisome for Whisper than Oinkins.
Yeah.
Because
reducing Oinkins.
Reducing his zero to zero doesn't really hurt. But reducing a 4 to a 3 is a kind of a big deal. Reducing a 2 to a 1 is a really big deal. So
I showed him the dark side, and what's that one?
Blinded Pilot.
Blinded Pilot.
Yeah, I mean...
And I think I did that on Wedge. I don't know. We'll see.
I think Wedge is a little bit more concerning. Because Wedge's ability is just really good. Jake Farrell, I mean, he can dance around and get out of arcs and move around. But okay.
Yeah, so I might have done it on Wedge because I thought he was going to flip around.
You know.
So if I could hit him with Blinded Pilot, he wouldn't.
Wedge almost has 4 attack dice. Kind of has like 3.5 because of that reduced agility.
See, I used a 2 hard. That's a 2 hard, right? Or is that a 1
hard?
No,
it's a 1.
1 hard, okay. Yeah, I had to drill out the center to shove the LED light up, and so it doesn't quite stay on the base that well. I got to do a better job of it next time, but it's the first time I ever soldered anything. All right, so I'm definitely Whisper is going after Wedge, so I barrel rolled to see if I could get within range one. So now I'm checking for range one, I think. And
you barely pulled it off.
Range one, yeah.
Oh, that's not okay.
So, and I'm outside his arc, and I've got a target lock on him.
Oh, that's a bad day.
I think I've calloused him as well. So, yeah. 5 die. I'm pulling them over. I think I'm using target lock. Oh, no. Why didn't I use target lock? I think I forgot that target lock was there. Oh, well. Okay, so I hit him with a crit, so I'll show you the dark side happens now, even though Oinken shoots second. So he can't fire. So I did have it on Wedge. Now, why? So that just means the next time that Wedge is able to fire, well, he's kind of stupid. He should flip it now. I should have chosen something else. But
yeah, that was probably not a great call. Oh, well, it's Lord, okay. I mean, Wedge.
Pilot skill 0 though. Oh yeah, I took 2. Yeah.
Wedge is kind of smoking.
And hopefully I did the right thing and went after Wedge, even though he's not at... Oh, I did, because I forgot he still had it. Oh, he's range 3.
I think Wedge is the right ship to kill first.
Yeah.
Because I think his ability is more effective against you. It's not really terribly effective against Oinkins, but his list, if he can take Wedge off the, or take a Whisper off the table.
Okay, yeah. Once again, Aaron's very nice because I forgot to do my Whisper actions, and he's going to let me do them, even though we've moved on to the next attack.
Mm.
So I've got to be better about that. Thank goodness he let me do it.
He's understanding. Well, I think Aaron was more about having a fair, fun game than...
Yeah, yeah. Well, we tried to help each other out. Like, I had to remind him he had Pilot Skill 0 now, and that he was going to move first.
Yeah, those... You remember those little critical hit tokens they gave us?
Uh-huh.
We should use those.
For what? Oh. For what?
Well, he took a critical hit that made him Pilot Skill 0.
Oh. You
should put one next to a ship as a reminder.
Okay.
That's the whole purpose of them.
Okay. I didn't understand that. Oh, I hit him. Wedge is gone.
Yeah, I mean, I think without... Well, so here's an interesting fact. If you guys had, for some ridiculous reason, came to the...
Yeah, he was very nice after killing his ship to allow me to do the Whisper move. Thanks, Aaron.
If you had came down to final salvo with all the ships on the table,
uh-huh.
You have the same amount of green dice on both sides.
Really?
Yeah, you've got 7.
Uh-huh.
You got 4 from Whisper and 3 from Oinkins. He's got 3 from Wedge.
Yeah.
And 2 from Jake and 2 from... So he got 7 as well.
That's
you just
true.
Took 3 of his green dice off the table.
Huh.
And you made it very difficult for him to take 4 of yours off the table.
All right,
by taking down Wedge.
So he just B-stand me. And I get... He's going after. Yeah, he doesn't realize how much power that has when it's cloaked. So 4 defense dice and a focus.
Yeah, 4 defense dice and a focus is hard to.
And later
get
on this match, I'll actually take as my action. I'll take an evade.
Ooh.
So if I hit him, I've got an evade, 4 defense tokens,
oh.
and a. And an eyeball, so
and a focus, So. Oh, that's nasty!
It's really hard to hit Whisper if you do it right and actually get a hit. That's why it also forces me to fly a little bit better because I learn how to fly better because I've got to be able to hit something every time after I decloak. Otherwise, I'm open and ready for hits, which I think he takes advantage of that here coming up. So what?
That's your average. On focus evade.
Focus evade with 4 dice, average of what?
3.5 evades.
3.5 evades. 4. Oh my goodness.
3.5.
So you that's the average. That's not the
maximum.
That's
average, yeah. Yes.
So on 4 dice,
you're 1
with an evade and a focus, I average 3.5 evades.
You're 100% for 1 because of the focus token.
Yeah.
98% to get 2 evades.
Oh my goodness.
84.8% for 3, 51.9% for 4.
And if I have the 5th dice at range 3?
15.
Oh, my Lord.
Well, no, I mean...
Oh, so that's 3.5 with
Well, that's with 4 dice.
With
now,
4
if
dice.
You were at range 3, it would be 5. So the numbers all go up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. All right, so his Outer Rim Smuggler's moving, and there was a asteroid, so that's why he didn't do a big turn.
He was trying to dodge that asteroid.
Yeah.
Asteroid has caught... it made his maneuvering awkward here with Outer Rim Smuggler.
He's going to boost.
It's probably... Well...
He boosts a lot with his Outer Rim Smuggler here, which is kind of crazy. Hardship boosting is really crazy.
I don't know where he's trying to go with it.
I think he's trying to get behind Whisper.
Yeah, but...
But he'd have to be behind and close with 2 attack die. Okay, so I'm trying to block him here. Well, and not fly off the board. That's the other thing.
Yeah, I mean, you didn't have a whole lot of good options there.
And I think I'll show him the dark side.
Well, Jake.
I'll show him the dark side.
Jake just needs the dark side in his life.
Yeah, I'm going to show Jake the dark side.
All the good.
I'm not sure what I did. I think I might have done Pilot School Zero. We'll see. What is it? Help me look. Oh. Couldn't see it.
You see that number? Okay, let's say he's range 1. 0.0. Even if he had a... Yeah. So anyway, so let's assume Jake got to range 1 with a focus and a target lock and was in arc so he could take a shot.
Oh, see, he went forward. He put himself in range 1 of me.
He
maybe he can, I can't remember. I think he does boost to get out of the way.
He boosts. Does that clear him out of range 1?
Yeah, I think so.
It did. He is squarely behind Whisper. But Whisper's a hard ship to predict where it's going to go.
Yeah, so it looks like I didn't. Let's see what I'm doing with Whisper. Oh, and he's boosting. He's barrel rolling
because of his action.
To get within 1, yeah.
Which is going to get a...
I think I'm going to do the hard left 1. I'm going to be beyond his arc.
Oh.
Right? If I do a hard left 1, I'm beyond the arc. Right?
Well, you could barrel roll the arc, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm out of his arc.
The
hard 1 with Whisper is kind of crazy.
Yeah. Hard 1 is just a ridiculous maneuver to begin with.
Yeah.
It can get you in so many great places.
And I think I take an evade here because there's really nothing to do.
So many times, a hard 1 is the perfect answer with Whisper. But if you get used to how Whisper flies, when you see where he declose, you can usually take a wild guess at where that... The problem is it's too late.
Oh, since I know I'm not going to fire, I take a cloak action.
You take your cloak action. I mean, the challenge about Whisper is, you know, once you see that decloak, but that's after dolls have been set.
Yeah.
So it's yeah, very difficult to block.
Yeah, but if you have a booster barrel roll, you can then count on it. But that's what you have to do. Range 2 against Jake, and I'm palping a crit.
You're really telling it with the striker, maybe. Because they do that. Changing the boost... The adaptive aileron move on a striker can really change her position.
Yeah, they can. I haven't played a striker yet, so.
They're,
I don't think I own one. It's one of the ones I have to buy.
They are hard to fly.
Are they?
Well, it's kind of like learning Whisper. They move way different. Because they do a boost before they do their template.
Oh. But they can curve, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's not like Whisper's Decloak, which is a 2 straight barrel roller boost.
Yes. Well, you also have...
All right, so I missed him there. He was able to evade. Oh, my gosh, he's got 2 hits against Whisper, but I've got the 4 dice. 5 dice.
Oh, see, firing...
It was range 3 with without a rim smuggler, so I've got 5.
Yeah, he's got a hard time now because he's got a whopping 4 dice against your 7. And getting any damage through on Whisper is going to be difficult. Because he's got 2 attacks.
Yep, so I evaded. Alright, I think I evaded.
And you've got him out PS with Whisper, which pretty much guarantees you're going to be cloaked by the time he's shooting.
Yep. Well, that's why I had to take care of Red Wedge first. So.
Yeah, I mean, now he's in trouble.
Yeah.
Well, even if you hadn't taken care of Wedge, you have initiative, so you're going to get the shot first and give a cloak.
Yeah, that's why I do that. Now, we've seen some people play builds with a 10 or 11 pilot skill, and Whisper sunk with that one.
Well, Whisper...
Unless I can pilot skill zero them.
Well, yeah, actually, that's a really good idea. If you can get them to pilot skill zero quickly...
And hold Whisper back until that happens.
Well,
right?
Whisper might be able to weather one turn of fire anyway.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. It depends.
It's not like you're running stealth device on Whisper.
Yeah, that's true.
Or, so the problem with stealth device on someone like Whisper is... Stealth device adds an agility, which is great, but if you ever take a point of damage, you lose stealth device. So the card flips over if you take once you take your first hit. Where with like Sindir failed, you just don't take a freaking hit ever. Where Whisper, if you catch Whisper and they don't get the cloak action, they only have two evade dice.
Yeah, so I think I might barrel roll to the left here beyond him, because I think a 2 barrel roll to the left puts me beyond his base.
Oh, with the decloak?
Decloak, yeah.
The two... Yeah, but...
I don't know which one I did.
I don't know...
I'm still thinking...
I think a barrel roll up the board and then...
I think I'm going to hit Oinken if I barrel roll up the board.
Because you're going to do like a hard through to Oinken.
Well, no. If I do a 2 forward, I'm going to hit him, right? Or do a 2 boost forward for decloak. I think I'll hit Oinken.
No, I was thinking up toward the top end of the board.
Oh, to the right. Well, it would go over... I don't think I could... Can I barrel roll over a debris?
No, not unless you got collision detector.
Okay, so I can't go to the right. So I think I do go to the left and decloak.
Hmm. We'll see how this works. Well, we're about to find out what he did.
I think I'm going to try to go to the left. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you pull him back.
You're way clear.
Oh, that's a 3. Is that
I think it's a 2.
Okay. I hope I didn't mess that up. It was a 3. I caught myself, though.
Good.
And I'm going to pull back, so I'm not going to hit him. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. You're right in his face, too. Let's see what he does. Whisper. The high PS that can block. Barrel roll for a block. Oh, God. Decloak into a block. That would be so epic. God, no shenanigans.
Well, the thing is, I wouldn't be able to cloak then.
Hmm. Well, no. You still get to execute your maneuver.
Oh, that's true. Because I go last. That's true.
You haven't executed your maneuver yet.
It's true. It's probably going to be a 1 of something. I think it's going to be a 1 right. Because I know he's going to move first and move out of the way.
I don't think it's going to be super rare that a decloak action is ever going to put you in a position, or ever even have the potential to get you in a position where you can block someone. But you know, if you can pull it off, more power to you. And show me a video. Put the link in the descriptions if you pull that off. Ever, that's awesome.
All right, I'm flying around now because that's what I got to do. I put myself out of position here, so I'm just checking because I was wondering if 3 hard was going to put me on the asteroid.
It would have absolutely.
So I was just wanted to see if I made the right choice.
Yeah, Decimator does not have the greatest doll in the world.
No, it doesn't. So I'm depending on where he moves. I think I don't get a shot on him.
But with a 360 art, do you need a great doll?
Oh, that's true. Well, it'd be nice. Like the Falcon has the hard 1.
The Falcon has a ridiculously good dial for having a 360. He's not a great dial, but it's a good dial. It's not a PTL dial. I've tried.
Oh, looky.
It's okay with NIMS or Neum Num crew, but not great. It's really hard to run PTL on a Falcon. Yeah, I think the the turrets are going to do a lot of work in this matchup.
So he took a focus. That's good. And he's now going to...
He's going to boost to try to get Arc on the Decimator.
Decimator, yeah.
Which I think he does. I mean, I don't think a two-dice attack on a Decimator is going to dent it very badly.
Well, I mean, I've got zero. I mean, I've got zero defense. So what he makes, he takes. I take.
He's not going to get through the shields, though.
That's true.
So he can't.
You've only got two shields left.
Yeah, you only have two shields and 12 hold behind
him. He's trying to get me down to half value for points.
Yeah. He needs to get what, four holes to do that? No, am I thinking wrong? He needs to get six more damage
eight,
on you.
Yeah, eight total, so six more damage, yeah.
It's a lot of work for a little ship, man.
Okay, so he's
Going to get it into its three dice.
Yeah, he's spinning the focus to get it within range one, but that means I'm in range one, and I've got Show Me the Dark Side on him, so I'm going to palp a crit probably with four dice, and it's going to get through.
Yeah,
and,
oh yeah.
And expertise.
Oh, that was probably a mistake for him.
Yeah, range one on Oiken with expertise, and I've got target lock on him.
Well, he's...
And I've got Palpatine on him.
He's behind the curve in this
one. Yeah, yeah. He's trying... We were talking about it while we were playing. He realized that he was in a bad way and was trying to get points. So he's going after...
Right now...
He's going after the Decimator to knock me down points.
He's doing what he needs to do, which is make opportunities for the dice to like him. Because...
All right, so I did a one hard like I thought, and now I'm going to barrel roll up his butt.
Mm.
So I'm a one right behind him.
Nice. Oh, Lord. That A-Wing's in a bad place.
Yeah. But both of them are range one hits.
But he's doing what he needs to do to give him an opportunity.
Exactly, to get points. Because we were actually, to win, I had to beat him by 3 points.
Right.
That's what we said. So he's doing what he can to make sure that I don't get those 3 points difference. Which
Well, he needs to get damage and get Oinkins off the board. But to do that, he's got to get dice rolled. He's got to roll some dice to attack.
Okay, I don't think I hit him at all.
Well, 3 of 8 dice can be a little challenging to push through.
Yeah, I didn't get him at all, so...
I mean...
Now he's firing.
If the dice...
I think he has 3 hits.
Right now, he's presenting himself with an opportunity for the dice to work in his favor. I mean, I wouldn't rely on the dice, but when you're down on a match, getting the dice and giving them the opportunity to help you is always a good idea.
Yeah.
When you're up on a match, you don't want to do that. You want to make it a sure shot. So.
Yep, he hit me for 2, I think. Oh, 3.
Ooh.
He did hit 3 hits on me.
Right, so you got half the work.
That
you
was
need
worth
done.
It, exactly. Even if I happened to hit him hard.
Did the Decimator fire yet?
No, not yet. He fires next because he's a pilot skill 6, and Jake Farrell is the 7. So I get 4 attack die, and I am going to. I palped one of them. So yeah, I've got 4 hits. Oh no, I'm not. I'm sorry. I'm using my target lock.
Yeah.
And I rolled an eyeball, so I got a hit. So I've got 3 hits and a crit.
Ooh.
So if he does not roll an evade, he's done. 1-shot kill.
Yeah, but Jake's not a chump. I don't think that's going to happen.
Let's see. I'm explaining. I went ahead and... I think I had an eyeball on the other one beforehand, and I chose to target lock and re-roll it, because if I were to get something else, I could have possibly had 2 crits. I think I took the chance with that, because no matter what, I was guaranteed 1 crit for that one.
You get 3 evades.
Okay, so that...
That looks like 3 evades.
That takes place. No, it's not three because the I'll show you the dark side hit.
Mmm. Oh. So he takes one damage to his hull. Right.
And I think I try to show him the dark side a second time. I'm not sure, though.
Well, you don't have an action to do it a second time, do you?
Oh, next turn. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Once again, Aaron, thank you. You're being a gentleman and giving me the chance to recloak when I forgot to do it at the end of the attack.
He's a gentleman and a scholar.
He is, yes, because that would have...
That would have been a painful lesson to learn.
Yeah. So, folks, when you're playing with me, the only way I'll learn is to say, no, you can't do that.
Yeah.
The attack is over. I won't, I'll be pissed at myself, not at you. So, catch me if you can.
Okay. So, what do we got?
He's going after Whisper.
Well, yeah, good luck.
Two hits, I think, and I've got a...
That's the best he can do at that range is two hits.
Yeah.
You got four of aid dice.
I didn't hit Jake Farrell, so I did not get the focus. I only get the focus if I hit something.
Ah!
The other ones happen on attack, no matter what, but...
actually has to hit.
Whisper actually has to hit to get the focus.
Right on.
Yeah, so if I hit...
Did you manage to kill freaking Jake without taking his shields down?
I might have. We're going to see. We'll see if I can't remember what I did, so...
That would have been epic.
Yeah, now we're talking.
So what do you do with Jake in this position?
That's why there's going to be a pause here. Aaron and I were actually talking about it, and I told him I didn't know what to do. You need to get half hits... And I told him he needed eight more, and then Danielle pointed out, well, no, eight more, and I'm like, no, those shields count. And we're like, oh, yeah, that's right, you only need three more.
Yeah.
And he's like, okay, I got to go after Awaken then. And so then he concentrated on Awaken to get me down to half.
Yep.
Which was the right decision to do. Because he knows he's going to, he had to do that.
Well, I mean, it's a challenging spot to be in. If you're gonna try to go for the swing for the fences and try to go for the win, if you're Aaron, you know, it's hard to decide who to go after because Whisper's going to be a pain in the buttocks.
Yeah, it is
for that's, either one of them to kill.
Well, and that's why I told him to go after we realized it was only three. I told him to go after Oinken. He had to get down half. Because, once again, he may not have... Even if he's not vying for first place, he wants to make sure he gets second. Because the people playing the third and fourth place game, he still needed to have more points than them.
Right.
But thanks to the match against you, he had 200 on the last.
What'd
you
yeah,
do?
Two,
you did that. You did 1 or 2 points of damage on...
No, I did three.
3 points of damage.
I got 3 points of damage and one shot on Jake. And that was all the damage I did the entire match.
Ugh. So that gave him a 200-point win.
I need to learn how to take my own advice. By the way.
Yeah, you forget how to fly for some reason when a tournament comes around. If it's not a tournament, you fly fine. If it's a tournament, you just forget to fly right.
No, that list that I've been flying, I mean, every time I put it on the table, I learn.
And that's Dengar and...
It's a Jumpmaster and the IG, yeah.
Jumpmaster and IG, okay.
It's no longer
with
Dengar.
Okay, so you're doing the Brobots thing, okay.
Yeah, the Brobot without two aggressors.
Yeah. All right, so I decloaked.
It's to be honest with you, it's a challenging because the two ships behave so much differently.
All right, I think hopefully he does a three easy. I think that's what he's going to do.
Thinking you're gonna?
No, he's not. He's playing the hold back and fire philosophy,
which
works fine if Whisper misses. But if Whisper doesn't,
wonder if he could get a resistance synthesizer in this list.
So I told him to. Here's what we're talking about.
Yeah,
of what he needs to go for, and I think at some point we had a lengthy discussion about which one to go for.
So, if you were building this list again, would you try to fit in a resistance sympathizer? Or would you go with the Outer Rim smuggler?
Does that end up being that's a captive, resistance captive, sorry. What's a resistance sympathizer?
It's the new generic for the Falcon.
What does it do?
It has the same stat line as the normal, as every other Falcon pilot.
Yeah, but what's
the difference? But it has 3 green dice. That's an excellent question. I think you might be able to do it. It would be pretty much slick, but...
No, he was smart to do the one, because I forget about his boost action. Really, that's... That gives him great maneuverability there. So.
Dang it. I'm failing, working stupid app.
All right, so I moved one. I was hoping to block him, and I think I did. We'll see. I was hoping he was going to go forward. I can't remember now. I've slept since then. But that was the whole idea, is I was going to creep along and see if I could get him to run into me.
Ooh, Lord, yeah. That is a big point difference.
38 to what? 27. Oh, no. That's not a good trade-off.
Yeah, you'd have to come up with four more points in this list. Well, I mean, the only thing you could run it without any of the upgrades and take in the proton torpedoes and be able to fit it.
I don't think that's worth... I don't know. Having three ships on the table is really powerful.
Well, I mean, it still would keep you the three ships. You just lose the upgrade cards on your Falcon. But you get an extra green dice and two more hull on a shield. So three more hit points and an extra attack dice.
I'm showing him the force, and I'm wanting him to... I'm showing him the force, and I wanted him to find the one. I think that was Pilot Skill 0. Can't even see that, can you?
No, we got some serious glare.
Oh, I think that's what Danielle said, serious glare. So I held it up, and then
she don't damaged remove it. Cockpit. Yeah.
Oh, she said that's worse.
You slept, but you still remember what Danielle said to you?
Yeah. Damaged cockpit.
Damaged cockpit, pilot skill 0.
Pilot skill 0. I might write out some cards next time just to hold it up so we don't have to get the small cards and actual index cards.
Well, in the future, we could actually do... well, no.
Oh, he flew on. That's debris, though,
He
hit the debris.
We might lose a shield to debris.
That was a green maneuver. Well, that's not the one that does that. He's rolling, and he get a hit, not a crit, so it's fine. But now he's in range one of me, too, so...
Yep.
Okay, let's see what I do. See, this... I should have...
You should have done the one.
Should have done the one, and I didn't learn my lesson, even though I was saying in my head, you know, one's really effective. Instead, I did a two.
And you bumped Jake.
I bumped him, and I don't have a shot anywhere. And so
this is where I take damage. The decimator has a shot.
No, but Whisper doesn't, so I'm not going to be able to get my cloak back.
Oh, so Whisper just became vulnerable.
Yeah, so I think he's going after... He might be going after... He might...
Yeah.
I think Decimator might be hitting Whisper because Whisper's open.
You mean the Falcon?
Falcon, sorry.
The thing is that the Falcon's not going to be able to kill it. I don't know. Is that range one?
Range one... I don't know.
If it's range one, there's a really far outside possibility. There's a possibility. But if it's not range one... He's not... There's no way.
Yeah, so I'm palping a crit.
Yeah, honestly...
He needs a defense. I think he got one.
I hate to say it, in this position...
So we took a crit. He takes that one, and I I Kylo Ren'd him through his shield and killed him.
Oh! I might have saved... Well, no.
Yeah, I Kylo Ren'd him through his shield. Because... That hurts, right?
Yeah.
Ow.
So Jake dies with a shield token on.
Yeah, Jake dies with a shield token.
Poor guy. So. You know, shields aren't everything, right?
Well, apparently with Kylo Ren, that's pretty evil if you only have two hull. I just need two rounds to take you out.
Yeah, an A-Wing. Kylo Ren can do some work on an A-Wing.
Well, on some of the swarms, too, the X-Wing swarms, right? I can pop, pop, pop.
Well, they have three.
They have three? Okay. Two defense dice. He did go after me. And so I think I lost three. Did I lose three? Two or three? I can't remember. Oh, no. He went after Ordkin.
There's a...
Oh, I don't know. Maybe it was the other one.
Someone needs to break out a missile. Breaks out a Lieutenant Blunt to go kill Whisper.
Yeah, I probably would have fired on Whisper. No, that's right. He did fire on Whisper, and I got lucky, and I rolled two evades.
Yeah, I love that ability, right?
Lieutenant Blount. When attacking, the defender is hit by your attack, even if it does not suffer any damage.
Yeah.
What does that mean? He does one attack? What does that mean?
It means it's considered a hit.
But you don't take damage.
Well, maybe.
What else do you play with that? Okay.
I will show you. He has a missile slot, right?
Uh-huh.
Where is that stupid missile? Oh, what's it called?
All right, so we're talking about what he should go after. Again. No, I think this was the
first
time. Advanced homing missiles. Discard this card to perform this attack. This attack hits, deal one face-up damage card to the defender, then cancel all dice results. Well, so that allows, if it hits...
It always hits!
It always hits.
With Lieutenant Blunt, that card...
Advanced homing missiles always hits. With a face-up damage card, too.
So it means Lieutenant Blunt just rolls in, gets at range 2, and goes, here's a face-up damage card.
That's great.
Which could one-shot Whisper if they get the 2-point by some dumb chance.
Yeah, that's true. Yes, they could. It could, because it goes through the shields. You could one-shot Whisper with that. That's true. That's evil.
It's a little ridiculous. The good ship to fly that on.
So that was Captain Blunt.
Lieutenant Blunt.
Lieutenant Blunt with advanced homing device. So Lieutenant Blunt says even if you attack misses, it's considered a hit. And the advanced homing missile says do a face-up damage card. So it does... not on a hit, on a hit. So they work in concert to guarantee one face-up damage. And if it happened to be Whisper, and you got... I pulled the 2 damage card, which is the most common card in the damage deck, critical damage card in the deck, then you one-shot, bypass shields, kill Whisper with that damn homing missile.
Yeah. The problem is you only get one shot out of it. Now, this is Xena 5, so it doesn't cost but like 20 points to field it. I have to figure out.
Okay. All right, so we've got dials. He's doing a 2.
I think it's 22.
Too hard, because he didn't want to bump me. That was good flying right there, right in the open space. Target locking, Captain Crunch, and then let's see. I forget what I do.
No, it's 20 points because that's 3, and Lieutenant Blunt is 17.
Oh,
well, 20 points. ship combo for you in a rebel fleet.
Well, that might be a possibility to play for Mario.
Oh shit!
Mario Kart.
Mario Kart.
Mario Kart. Yeah.
Here, boom! Take a crit. I'm gonna bite you.
All right, I'm flying around.
Do 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 do. Not sure Xenafeb's what I want to play in Mario Kart, but
yeah. A-wings are really powerful in Mario Kart.
So are interceptors.
As we found out.
Remember, I won with an interceptor last time?
Yeah. Well, I think that's because Danielle ran into the wall. Mario Kart X-Wing. Coming to a store near you. Oh, I do hit him.
Oh, that's not okay.
Well, it is because
it's also the only ship on left on the table, so it's not a problem.
So he can't fire on me, so it's okay. I don't have my stealthy stealth.
Hmm. But you hit him, so it doesn't really matter. You're perfectly stealth.
I'm perfectly stealth.
You just dived under a ship, so
super shell, super stealth. All right, so I'm firing him. It is through obstruction. I'm re-rolling my target lock. I'm palping that crit, and I've got 3 hits.
Not making life easy.
And he's got, I don't know. I can't tell. There's too much glare.
I think it's an eyeball. So would you have conceded if you were Aaron?
No, because he needed to go for half damage. He's within half damage range. Heck no. I don't concede. It's fun to play and go down in flames. Well, we call it a rogue one moment.
Oh!
I don't fly away either to prolong it if I'm behind. I still try to do damage. I think that's kind of silly just to let it go, you know? Do you do that?
I look for opportunities. Unfortunately, sometimes that looks like me flying away.
No, I think I end up flying away with Whisper. Oh, I think I did a 2 damage. He did a 2 damage on that one.
Oh, nasty. Yeah, it looks like it.
Yep, 2 damage. So he achieved his objective. He's got me down. He's got me down. What did he do? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it.
He got half.
He got half. Now, the chances of getting 8 more is slim. So I think I told him, go after Whisper now to try to blow it. But the chances of him getting 8 more on... What would you have done? Would you have gone after Whisper or continued with Oinken?
I would have tried to continue with Oinken.
Oinken, sorry.
Just because I think I can get the damage in. You need to keep blocking Whisper so Whisper doesn't eat him. Because Whisper, 4 or 5 dice attacks, that Outer Rim Smuggler is not going to be alive long. It only has 10 health. You know, 2-3 turns, that thing's going to be gone.
Yeah, I made a really bad decision coming up here on this next move. I remember my movement dial for this next move.
Oh, Lord.
And it's not good. Of course, I didn't follow my theory of using one hards. So...
But you weren't cloaked, I think that throws the theory out the window.
Yeah, I think I did a 3 easy to the right. Because I thought he was going to do a hard turn, and he didn't. I think he just went forward.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so...
Well,
either that or he did a K-turn, one of the two.
And you ended up
next to him at range 1. Yeah. I think that's what happened here.
If you're not... Well, yeah. It depends on how the arcs land. If Whisper ends up not having the Falcon and arc, that's a bad day.
Yep, I think that's what happened. But we'll see here, because I think he did do a K-turn.
Because you're going to think you have the shot on him. No, he moves first, doesn't he? Yeah.
He moves first. Oh, see, look. I did a 3 hard. not a three easy. I pulled the, instead of setting my dial, I pulled the movement template out. Foreshadowing. Yeah, no, he turns away. That's really weird. I didn't expect that. I thought he was going to go toward Oinkin.
Yeah, my expectation would have been like a two hard.
Yeah, I should have done a one hard. Well, yeah, Oinkin or two hard, one of the two.
Well, if he had done a one hard, he might have still blocked your three.
So I'm doing a...
Because large bases are beast.
I'm doing a two hard, and I'm out of range.
Yep. Which may have been what I was looking for. Oh. To get the ships divided.
Yeah, that makes sense. I was showing him, I actually, if I were to take a stress, the base lights up red, but it's a faint red, you can't quite see it.
No. Not to mention, I don't even think you can see the pegs.
Watch okay. This, look at this.
Oh!
Horrible flying on my part, look at that.
Well, I mean...
And I know I'm not going to get the... I'm not going to get a shot. And I can't barrel into it. So
is that horrible
cloak?
So here's the real question. Is that horrible flying on your part? Or horrible flying on... Or excellent flying on his part?
I don't know. I just know it ended up badly for me.
It definitely ended bad for you. But it may have been him second... Or guessing what you were going to do.
Yeah, so he gets three dice on me. Plus target lock. And all I have the four defense. And so I think he gets two or three through.
Oh. Well, this is the really...
Here he goes. He's the only one that has a shot.
This is the excellent... The gambles he has to make win.
And I get nothing.
Oh.
Nothing. I rolled not a single evade. I rolled too soon is what happened. He wanted a target lock. And so I re-rolled, because I did have eyeballs. I did evade there. Who knows?
So if he hadn't done the re-roll, he probably popped a shield off.
Yeah.
But, I mean, this is the opportunities Aaron's got to make to be able to get back into this.
Yeah.
So I think that was an excellent move by him.
That was.
To catch you off guard.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Unfortunately, he wasn't able to capitalize on it much.
Yeah.
Wasn't able to capitalize on it. But, I mean, the dice is just not in his favor at this point. You have to have some spectacular rolls, and the odds are that's never going to happen. But he's at least got to give himself the opportunity to have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
He can't play conservative at this point.
Okay, so I'm decloaking to the right, and I think I do a one hard to just get me around. And I think he does a one hard to the right or two hard. One hard.
Ooh, yeah,
that's good.
Did you see that coming?
Yeah, but yeah, of course. Otherwise, you'd fly off the board. But he's still in range, and he's
But he could have done a word hard to the other side.
That's true. He could have flown away. I didn't think he was going to disengage, but...
But, I mean, the Decimator's still got forward momentum. And he might have been able to get just an engagement with the Decimator and not have to...
Oh, I forgot. He's going to boost. So he's going to get closer to me.
Well, hopefully you stuck to your one hard theory.
I hope I did the one hard theory. I think this is a two hard. I think I just missed the asteroid. Look at that.
Decimators don't have a one hard, do
or
they?
Two hard. Yeah, they don't have a one hard. Two hard. Bam! Yep. I just missed it. I was so happy. So I was really nervous that I wouldn't make it. But I figured I had enough health left that it didn't matter if I landed on the asteroid. And I was out of firing distance, right?
Right.
So I think that boost put him beyond three.
I don't know. Maybe he's got a shot.
And I cloak.
Because obviously you're not going to have a shot. I'm surprised he didn't do a one hard the other direction.
To go away?
To go toward him.
Oh.
You're facing away right now.
No, I don't know. One hit against my four defense.
To be honest, I think you may have been thinking he was going to
make it. Four defense dice plus one for range, five defense dice, and I evade.
I think you may have been thinking he was going to turn the other way when you set your dial.
Okay, so that's there's no shots. We're back to dials. Sorry, back to dials, guys. It's a catchy phrase.
Well, they took it for a reason.
There's a definite ebb and flow to this of rhythm. I'm just surprised we went almost to time here. I think we're within 5 minutes of time. So even though it looks like it looks like Aaron's
he's in dire straits.
Yeah, but he was able to play the entire match and keep alive, which is a testament to good flying, you know?
It is. Aaron made some brilliant moves that made it really hard for you to get back into the fight.
And look at that. One didn't go off the board. And he's going to boost forward, I think, now, because he wants to try to get close to me. There's a cure song.
Did you forget to your decloak?
Yeah, I did. I forgot the decloak. I forgot the decloak, folks.
Oh, no.
Oh, he's letting me take the decloak.
Oh, that's...
Yeah, Aaron, you're too nice. You shouldn't allow me to take the decloak afterwards. But I think he started moving before...
He gave you the opportunity.
Yeah, and I just let him finish moving. Yeah.
Mm.
I should have told him, wait, a decloak, but it didn't happen. All right, three easy. Puts me within range one. And I don't show him the dark side. I think I target lock on him.
You get into those.
Yeah, I target log him. Pull that. I forgot to pull that off from last time. So. All right. See which one he goes after. Run away.
You do a K turn?
No. I'm just running away. Because I'm letting Awaken take him.
Well, are you burning away to try to get yourself into a good position to get a reapproach?
Right. I think I do a one on the next maneuver so I can try to do that bit. I do a one hard to see if I can flip around. Because I don't want a K turn because then I...
You're off the board at this point.
Yeah. Well, no, I'd K-turn on this one because I wouldn't have had... I would have been open.
Yep. I think with a full health whisper, you can risk it. You only have a two-dice attack ship at
yeah,
range
I didn't
three
that.
Of you.
I should have done the K-turn. All right, so I Palpatine four hits.
And you can always use...
One evade, so three hits.
If you know you're going to leave whisper exposed by doing something like a K-turn... You can save Palpatine for your defense if he shoots at you.
Oh, that's true. Oh, geez. Yeah, I did two crits on that.
Oh, Lord.
A hit and two crits.
So that puts him at, what, four health?
Let's see if we see what they did. What is it?
A lot of glare. That's a two damage
glare.
There.
There's a two damage. And...
Damage sensor array.
Which he can't do actions, but those that are on that card.
Oh, Lord, that puts him at three health. Mm. Oof.
Yeah, so that was a big hit. Okay, so now he's attacking Whisper, I think.
He should have went for the Decimator.
He is going for the Decimator. I think if that one's pilot skill zero, I don't know. Hopefully I held these up.
Good Lord. A lot of turns, not a lot of damage dealt, and then all of a sudden here it comes.
Oh, yeah. That's what it was. I got two pilot skill zero crit cards, which on a decimator doesn't matter because you're already at pilot skill zero.
Well, pilot skill zero or reduced agility?
Oh, sorry.
You're reduced, thinking of reduced agility.
Yeah, so I had 2 reduced agility.
Ah.
So which doesn't matter. That's a great crit. If Oinkin's going to have a crit, it should be...
Yeah.
It should be reducing his agility to zero.
At this point, I'm not sure I wouldn't try to bump an Oinkin. The problem is that the Outer Rim Smuggler is going to move first.
And he'll boost. Yeah.
He's trying to stay out your bump.
He's also trying to go for Whisper.
Yeah.
And he realized at range 3 with Whisper with cloaking would be 5 dice, and there was no way he would have hit Whisper.
Yeah, that's kind of long odds. The best of situations. But 2 dice against 5?
Yeah.
I don't even want to think about the statistics on that.
So
it's
I did do a 1 hard, and I think I take an evade. Or maybe I think I cloak again.
Is there a chance? It ain't good.
So he did, what did he do? Was that a 2 easy? 3 easy. 2 or 3 easy.
0.43. 2 dice at range 5 against 5. That's assuming no mods for Whisper.
Yeah.
And full mods for the attack, which isn't going to happen.
Yeah. All right, so what did I do? Oh, he's trying to get rid of and flip that card over, and he didn't do it.
Oh, he has to roll it. Yeah, that's right. For damage sensor array, you have to roll a card to flip it.
I think I did roll it too hard, and I got right up on him. No, too easy. I still think I'm at range 1, though. And I'm going to target lock him. Instead of doing, I'll show you the dark side.
Well, I don't know if it really matters to you at this point in the game.
No, I mean, if you guys pilot skill 0, who cares?
Yeah, but I think you've already used those.
I have.
The only you've basically exhausted all the good crit cards at this point. So, yeah, at this point in the game, I mean, you've already pulled God knows how many cards.
It'll go through his shields.
Yeah, you go through his shields.
So,
yeah, okay, about that.
Target lock with expertise is really powerful.
Well, the one thing about it going through the shields is think about Rebel Regen.
Okay, I'm target locking. Just a second, hold on. What's Rebel Regen?
Like R2-D2, you can recover a shield if you do a green maneuver.
Yeah.
Kylo's I'll Show You the Dark Side just ignores that.
All right, so 3 hits here, and he gets 1 defense dice. And he does not defend. And that's it, I think. Yep.
Yep.
That was good flying, though, because we only had like 5 minutes left. So just remember, I'll show you the dark side.